What's up, YouTube? Sonic Gentile back again. Part 3, Proving the Existence of God. With the advancement of knowledge in the areas of science, we continue to discover evidence that God does indeed exist. Extensive studies on human DNA are revealing facts evolutionists don't want to hear. To trace back the origins of humans, scientists have conducted numerous studies on the mitochondrial DNA and the Y chromosomes of wide selections of humans. Mitochondrial DNA is unique since it's passed down only from our mother, and of course only men carry the Y chromosome, and men receive it from their fathers. What can they discover from all this? Well, they can estimate how long ago human DNA originated from, especially the mitochondrial DNA and the Y chromosome. However, scientists using evolution as a guide first place human, the first human female, at around 200,000 years ago. However, more recent studies have discovered that actual mutation rate of mitochondrial DNA is around 800 years. And unfortunately for scientists, this places the first human female at around, ready? 6,500 years ago, around exactly when the Bible says Eve lived with Adam. How about the age of the Y chromosome? For some reason, the dating of the first male is actually a lot younger than the first female, by even a couple thousand years. Why would this be? Adam could not have been 1,000 years younger than Eve, right? There has to be an explanation. The famous story from Genesis answers this problem. The male's common father goes back to Noah. However, Noah, with his three sons, had their three wives, whose mitochondrial DNA dates back to Eve, with Adam in the Garden of Eden. Pretty amazing, huh, guys? Well, thank you for watching. Proof of the existence of God. God bless everyone.